In a world of peace and prosperity, life was full of excitement and adventure. Where people were positive, kindness prevailed, and nothing much ever went wrong, there lived a boy who dreamed of building inventions. Success was for all. Nothing was impossible. You could do anything. Be anyone. There was no limit. Life was there for the taking. All you had to do was take it.
Happening now, breaking of the dead virus.
But then, a disease known as sinus inflammation was released upon the world.
Americans who had been infected with the deadly disease.
No one knew what had happened.
To examine the worst outbreak in the history of the FBI.
They had no idea where the disease had come from or the evil force behind it.
The death toll is nearing 700. There is no treatment or vaccine.
In a small town, completely unaware, watching his favorite TV show, Star Trek, lived Dr. Barn, a young chemist. He never said much, but his mind was always thinking, waiting for an opportunity, and on this night, he was in for a real surprise.
Good evening. The Centers for Disease Control tonight elevated the virus to level one status, and here's what that means. It's their highest level of mobilization reserved for their largest scale response, requiring an agency-wide effort because the outbreak is now officially out of control.
This was his moment. He would find the cure. So, without a second thought, Dr. Barn got to work. Writing equations, running experiments, testing theories, making mixtures, writing more equations, running more tests, using every combination he could think of. But nothing seemed to be working. But nevertheless, he persevered, enlisting the help of his dog. Still nothing. But he wouldn't give up. But things only got worse. Finally, he gave in. He needed help. Printing hundreds of notices, Dr. Barn set off to plaster the town in hopes of finding an assistant. And who should find it?
And a madman trying to save the world.
I'm not a little boy, I'm an assistant chemist.
You are a little boy who's going to stay in this house till I get back. Do you understand?
Yes.
But he had other plans.
I'm here to be the assistant chemist.
This wasn't exactly what Dr. Barn had in mind, but he just needed help. So together they started cleaning things up. Starting from scratch seemed to be the best option at this point. Back to the pouring and mixing. It was better this time having someone to help, and even if it was messy at times, they persevered. Nothing could stop them. Was the duo of all duos, measuring, mixing and pouring, non-stop until they had something promising. Of course, being caught up in the excitement of their discovery, Dr. Barn neglected to think about the ramification of testing an unknown cure on his assistant. Dr. Barn fell into a complete state of utter despair. What had he done? He had no idea what had gone wrong or what to do. Everything seemed to be against him. Where was the error? What had been the miscalculation? It all seemed to be falling apart. The task was insurmountable. How could this be happening to him? It was too much to bear. Maybe he just wasn't meant to be a chemist. Finally, he dozed off into a peaceful slumber. He dreamed of the day he would roll out in the perfect car, going off without a care in the world. The sun shining, the breeze of success blowing his way. But that didn't last long. Soon he was racked by flashes of his own past, dealing with sickness as a child.
More tests.
Headaches.
Proceed with the injection.
The symptoms are only getting worse.
Take these and see if they help. I'm afraid there's nothing wrong here. Regret to inform you, Mrs. Vargas, your son has contracted a rare disease.
Is there anything you can do?
No.
Determined not to let any more people suffer as he had, he went back to work. And yes, his assistant was back. Turns out the shrinking effect wasn't long-lasting after all. On this beautiful day, as the disease ravaged the globe, everyone was doing their best to forget their worries and make the most of life while it lasted. not one for relaxing, Dr. Barn and his assistant were mixing their last hope for the cure. They all knew there was only one place that an explosion like that could come from. As the smoke cleared, something remained on the table. This was the moment of truth. Would this black glob that they had created be the cure? There was only one way to find out. And like that, in an instant, she started to feel better. They had done it. They had found the cure.
Happening now, we're following the breaking news.
Breaking news.
I'm Wolf Blitzer, you're in the
situation. A young chemist has discovered a cure for the sinus inflammation.
In the 143-year history of the Office of the Surgeon General, this has never happened.
Now confirmed that it is a man going by the name of Dr. Barnabas.
Who has discovered a cure for the deadly sinus inflammation disease.
Dr. Barn and his assistant became known worldwide. People were astonished that these two, a young chemist, student, and a local boy, could have discovered the cure.
We are still unsure exactly why this.
Breaking news. Young chemist discovered a cure for sinus inflammation.
It has been reported that the government and food manufacturers
across the world. But soon there was no doubt they had done it. The antidote was quickly injected into many food products, but mainly ice cream, because for some unknown reason it was found to be the most effective way to spread the cure.
Haagen-Dazs, Mariah's, have all signed on to start injecting their products with the antidote.
I'm
hoping this will be the fastest way to immunize the whole globe.
If there was one thing that Dr. Barn had learned, it was that life can be unpredictable, and we may never know how we got to where we are. But one thing is certain, it takes reaching past practicality for the unknown. It may seem impossible to stretch that far, but the universe is full of impossibilities and contradictions. All you have to do is strive forward. And make some of your own. And together, Dr. Barn and his neighbors, now friends, gorged on ice cream and went on to live very happy lives.